Hello world, it's Rahul.
Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial. So guys, today we are going to discuss DBSCAN, as this is one of the well-known data clustering algorithm in comparison to k-means or hierarchical clustering, what we have studied in last sessions. So DBSCAN groups together points that are close to each other based on distance measurement and a minimum number of points. So guys, DBSCAN stands for density-based spatial clustering of application with noise. So basically, it is a density-based clustering algorithm. So here, our parameter would be density. Means, it can also create clusters but based on density of data. So guys, we will discuss how this algorithm is better than any other clustering algorithm. But you have to watch this video till end, as I'll be explaining you the complete implementation of this algorithm. Let's start understanding this algorithm. So we have two major parameters for clustering the data based on DBSCAN, and that is epsilon and minimum points. So what is epsilon and minimum points? So guys, let me explain you in layman language. So here, epsilon is nothing but the radius of a circle. And when I say radius of a circle, then you must think that from where we are getting this circle and radius. So guys, let's say we have this point x, and from this point I will take a distance of, let's say, 2 units and draw a circle considering this as a radius, or you can say it as epsilon as well. Now what is minimum point? So guys, this is my data point x. Let's say I'm drawing other data point as well, nearby data point x. So this is my data point y and this is my data point z. Now if we look into the data point x, let's consider it as center, and by taking epsilon radius we will draw a circle. Now we will check how many minimum data points should be there inside this circle. So as I've mentioned, let's say minimum point is 3. So we must have 3 points inside the circle. But question arises, what does it signify for having 3 minimum data points inside the circle? Or what if we don't have minimum 3 data points inside the circle? Let's quickly understand this. So guys, if we are having 3 minimum points, then the point which we took as a center and drew the circle is considered as a core point. So here, data point x will be our core point, as it is satisfying the condition that there should be minimum of 3 points inside the circle when we take data point x as a center for the circle. Let's visualize all these things in bigger frame and see whether we can satisfy the condition or not. So here, if you can see on the screen, point A is our core point. Let's see how is this satisfying the condition. Let's create a distance that is epsilon, and by considering it as radius, let's draw a circle. So guys, if you can see, we are having minimum 3 points inside this circle. So we can consider it as core point. Let's look at point B. So we will follow the same steps what we did for point A. So we take a distance that is epsilon and draw a circle by considering point B as center and epsilon as radius. Now guys, if you'll see, we have only 2 data points inside this circle. But for considering it as core point, we must have minimum 3 points inside this circle. So this is not a core point. But if it is not a core point, then what is this? We have only 2 options for this. Either we can consider it as border point or noise point. So let's see the condition for border point first. So we will check whether point B is a neighbor of any core point or not. So here we can say that point B is a neighbor of core point A, as point B was coming inside the circle of a core point A. So we can state that point B can be considered as a border point. Now what about noise point? So let's have a look at point C. Again, we will take a distance of epsilon and by considering it as radius, draw a circle. Now we will check whether this is a core point, border point or noise point. So it doesn't have any data point inside the circle except itself. As it is not satisfying any of the condition, we can consider it as noise point or outlier. So guys, this is one of the biggest advantage of DBSCAN algorithm, that it identifies the outliers and directly eliminate without taking it inside any of the cluster. So guys, I hope till now you have understood what is epsilon, minimum points, core points, border points and noise point. Moving ahead, let's try to solve one real world problem. So guys, if you can see on the screen, we have one table. So let's understand what it denotes. So it is denoting the distance from one point to another. So distance from point P1 to P1 would be 0, as distance from itself will definitely be 0. So by same means, we are representing distance of each point with another point in the given table. This table is symmetrical, so left triangle would be same as right triangle. So here, we are only considering left triangle and diagonal would be 0. Now, let's define epsilon value as 2.3 and minimum points as 3 before going ahead. So guys, as we have data table and parameter values with us, now we only have to create clusters. Let's see how can we do that. So guys, let's look into point P1 first. We will check distance of point P1 from each point and see if any of the distance is less than epsilon value, that is 2.3. So we have only one distance less than 2.3 for point P1, that is 0 from itself. So we will consider it as border or noise point, as it is not satisfying the condition of minimum points. Let's move to next point P2 and check whether any of the distance is less than 2.3 or not. So here, point P2 has only one distance less than epsilon value, and that is 0 from itself. So again, we will consider it as border or noise point. Let's have a look at point P3. So distance from P3 to P3 is 0. Distance from P3 to P5 is 1.7. And distance from P3 to P6 is 2.3. Here, we have three data points which is having a distance of less than or equal to epsilon value. So we can consider this as a core point. Moving to point P4. We are having only two points with distance less than epsilon value. So we will mark it as border or noise point. Now point P5. So here, distance from P5 to P3 is less than 2.3. Distance from P5 to itself is less than 2.3. And distance from P5 to P6 is less than 2.3. So this would be considered as a core point, as it is satisfying the condition of having three minimum points. Now let's have a look at point P6. And distance from P6 to P3 is 2.3. Distance from P6 to P5 is less than 2.3. And distance from P6 to itself is less than 2.3. So again, it would be marked as core point. Now point P7. And P7 would be marked as border point or noise point, as it has only one distance that is less than epsilon value, and that is distance from P7 to itself. So guys, now we only have to check for point P8. And if you'll see, distance from point P8 to P4 is less than epsilon value, and distance from point P8 to itself is having a distance of less than epsilon value. So it would be considered as border or noise point. So according to table retrieved, we have three core points with us, that are point P3, P5 and P6, with minimum three data points inside the cluster. But what about the others, which doesn't satisfy the condition and mark as both border and noise point? Let's figure it out further, like which data point is border point and which data point is noise point. Okay, so we have one condition for border point is, our data point must have neighbor core point. So by seeing on data point P1, P2 and P7, we can directly map it to noise point, as it doesn't have any neighbor core point. Now let's have a look at point P4. So P4 has two data points, that is P4 itself and P8. But none of them is a core point. And if we check the distance of data point P4 from any of the core point, then that should be less than epsilon value. So distance from P4 to core point P3 is 4.7, and it's not less than epsilon value. Distance from P4 to core point P5 is 3.1, that is again not less than or equal to epsilon value, and distance from P4 to core point P6 is again greater than epsilon value, so it would be considered as noise point. Same applies on data point P8 as well, because P8 has one neighbor data point, that is P4, but data point P4 is not a core data point. Neither any of the core data point is having a minimum distance of 2.3 from data point P8, so it would be marked as a noise point. So guys, by visualizing all this, we can say that data point P3, P5 and P6 can be one cluster, and other points are just an outlier which can be discarded. Hope you guys like this video and understand the mathematics used behind this algorithm. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.